Bless your hearts. Thank you so much. Many, many decades ago, we were working on an album called American Woman. We were in the studio in RCA Studios in Chicago. And my old partner, Randy Bachman, he had a song and I had a song. And ironically, they were both in the same key. And we were messing around, throwing these two songs back and forth at each other. And our producer had an idea. He said, why don't we wait till tomorrow? Why don't you guys mess around with these two tonight and see if you can squash them together, sort of amalgamate the tunes and see what happens, you know, because they're both in a strange key. So we said, yeah, okay, we'll try that. And we went back to the hotel that night and we messed around a little bit. And when we went back the next day to the studio, we had figured a way to squash them together. And I guess producer's idea was a pretty good idea, because it's decades later and I still hear them on the radio squashed together all the time. So this is, it's not a full-blown band version of these two songs, but they're pretty recognizable, and this is kind of the way they sounded that night in the hotel when Randy and I first kind of squashed them together. This is two songs in one. Yeah. Response, it does sound that you're kind of in a pretty good Friday night mood. Are you in a good mood? Okay, well, those of you, a few of you that were here on Wednesday, you probably know what's coming now, but I will introduce this. This will definitely be the silliest, stupidest thing you will hear all evening. Probably the silliest thing you've heard for quite some time. The intro to this is almost longer than the musical piece itself, but I must explain. There are a lot of mitigating circumstances, what ifs, involved in this presentation, and I call this very simply, if Gordon Lightfoot's favorite singer were Rod Stewart. Now bear with me for the explanation. Let's say you were in Toronto for some reason and you were walking through the Rosedale section and you happened to be passing Gordon's huge ostentatious mansion. And if one of the windows in that castle were open about this wide, just as you were passing, and if Gordon had just been listening to his favorite singer, and if that favorite singer happened to be Rod Stewart, and if Gordon had been immediately inspired to jump up and run and grab his guitar, or run to the piano and start doodling around on the piano, and of course, if the planets were aligned properly that day, if all these things came to pass, you might hear something that sounds vaguely like this, only if Gordon Lightfoot's favorite singer were Rod Stewart. Pretty stupid. Well, to stray away from my own songs now, I'd like to do this for you because this is, it's such a beautiful old theater, and I could never come in here with my band. It would be far too loud, and I would melt everyone's fillings and hurt their ears. But for just piano and voice, I like to sit here like this. This is like having you all in my living room for a while, you know? This is... I like to do this because when I'm in a smaller venue like this beautiful theater, and I do love this theater, by the way, this won't be the last time I come here and do this. This is it's a favorite of mine. It's a song you all know. You've heard this for decades on the radio. It was written, I think, way back in the 1940s. But the familiar version to me, in fact, the version from which I learned it came out, I think, in 1959, 1960. It was done by a childhood hero of mine named Walden Cassato, who changed his name for show business purposes to Bobby Darin. I want to explain very briefly one more thing about this. I will be utilizing three-way independence for this number, meaning that my left hand will be doing something completely independent of the right hand, and the vocal will be completely independent of both hands. Ladies and gentlemen, this is extremely difficult, and I'm expecting thunderous applause when it's finished. As I said, this has been recorded by dozens of people, but I think the worldwide number one record was done by my hero, Bobby Darin, so I'll do this tonight for my new hometown, and also in great respect and admiration for the memory of Mr. Bobby Darin. I hope you like this. Oh, what a shot, baby. Such cheap media, and it shows it fairly white. Just a jackknife has only hit, babe, and it keeps it out of sight. And you know when it's sharp, but it is too big. Scarlet billows start to spread. She loves so, where's old Maggie? So there's never a trace of red. Down on the sidewalk come Papu's sunny morning. Lies a body just oozing light. Boom, someone's sneaking round the corner. Could that someone just drooping on down? Oh, that cement is just there for the wait, dear. Father Matrix and old Maggie's back in town. You hear about Little Miller? Oh, oh, he disappeared, baby, after drawing out all his hard-earned cash. And now Maggie spends just like a sailor. Look out!